Welcome to the Pathway Wellness Center, located on 303 Woodrow Wilson Drive, where recently we visited with Dr. Livingston A. Rasalam. He's the medical director of Pathway Wellness Center, founded Hope for the Suffering, Hope Rasalam Foundation, Ministry to Ministers, and the author of Yes, There is Hope for the Suffering. Here's Dr. Rasalam.
I am Dr. Livingston Rasalam. I'm a psychiatrist and I'm board certified in American Board of Psychiatry and Neurology. I've been in practice in the field of psychiatry since December of 1978. I worked about 16 years. I was in the Chicago area and I moved to Valdosta, Georgia in September of 1991. And I've been working in the local hospital, South Georgia Medical Center and Greenleaf Center. And I've served as the chairman of psychiatry for a few years. And now I'm in private practice in Valdosta. I have my own office at 303 Woodrow Wilson Drive. And as I said before, I'm actively practicing out of Greenleaf Center and do consulting work at South Georgia Medical Center.
What's some characteristics about the typical patient that visits Pathway Wellness Center?
I see children, adolescents, adults, as well as geriatric population. A lot of times people ask me whether I only see Christian patients. That is not true. I see people of every faith or someone who may not even have any faith in God. I see them too. But if people come and ask specifically for Christian therapy, that's something we do. I also have staff here who have a Christian background.
What about the recent tragedy at Virginia Tech where over 30 folks lost their lives?
Well, we have been watching the television lately and we have seen a lot of people acting inappropriately, especially the tragedy in Virginia where this young man, I would say in his 20s, who ended up killing about 32 or 33 bright youngsters who would have come up as great people in their lives, the cream of the crowd, I should say, because they were excellent students, motivated, studying hard, and they had high hopes. But all of a sudden, their life was cut short by the bullets of a young man who was so confused and psychotic. And When I was watching the television, I could see this man so angry, hostile, a lot of frustrations inside, and extreme paranoid delusions and also grandiose delusions. If I'm not mistaken, he was comparing himself to Jesus at one point, so which is basically grandiose. And when I look at this man, I mean, even before they started talking about it, I felt that he is more of a schizophrenic with delusions and hallucinations and grandiose ideas. I'm sure he has gone through mood swings. But in a nutshell, I mean, I feel he was a very paranoid guy, going through a lot of insecurities in life. He wanted to be somebody and this is the way he ended his life, by being somebody. And if you really notice, he sent the video of himself to the NBC because he wanted people to talk about him, and he, that's the way he felt he would be an important person, even though he was wrong. But in his delusions, that's the way he thought he is.
Emotional difficulties often leave an individual with a sense of hopelessness. Is there hope for everyone?
People ask me questions whether there is hope for my patients. I mean, I have parents asking me, family members asking me, patients themselves, I mean, in fact, not mentioning any names, I admitted somebody in the hospital the other day. One thing that she kept asking me is there hope for me? Am I going to get better? I always tell them, I cannot promise that you're going to be better or you're going to be well, but since your faith in God is there and solid, I can tell you through God nothing is impossible. So, yes, there is hope for people who are going through this or any kind of emotional difficulties or violent thoughts. Or
Pathway Wellness Center and Dr. Rasalam reach out to folks with various needs.
God helps us to help those in need, and locally as well as overseas. I mean, it's God provides the funds through our practice, and I still believe that that's God's money that He funnels through us in helping the needy locally as well as overseas. 1982-83 is when we formed the organization called Hope for the Suffering, primarily to help those in need and the suffering. And we also, along with that, had started a ministry called Ministry to Ministers, helping pastors, evangelists, missionaries who are going through hardships in their lives, who need therapy and who may need a friendship at times. And we do every 3 months a Ministry to Ministers dinner in a local restaurant where ministers of every background are invited, and mostly we have an average of 50 to 60 people come. They usually have a time of fellowship and worship and testimony, and one of the ministers is invited to preach in that program. Usually lasts about two and a half hours. And this is just to help those who are ministering to the needs of other people and who are pastors. They come as an evening of rest and relaxation, and ultimately to rebuild their relationship with God, because many of the pastors are lonely people, because they cannot share anything that they are going through with other people or other ministers. They hold it in, and they could be depressed, they could be even suicidal, but they won't tell anyone. In fact, years ago I remember calling a minister from the airport. I was going overseas, and I had an excessive feeling of wanting to talk to this minister. So I picked up the phone and called him from the airport. And his first question was, "Who told you to call me?" I said, "Well, I just called because your name kept coming." So he was upset. He said, "Maybe my wife told you to call." I said, "No, nobody did. God inspired me to call you." And he was very depressed and almost thinking of suicide at that time. So those are the things we offer to ministers and their families. And Hope for the Suffering has been functioning here as well as in India, where I am originally from. And God uses us to support the building of new churches. We have about 20 projects we were able to support all these years. So many people have started attending these churches, and churches have gotten bigger. And every time I go to India, I try to visit as many of these churches as possible. The other thing we are involved in is supporting the needy children who live with their family sometimes, otherwise in the orphanage or a home for the handicapped. That is a ministry I feel really blessed whenever I go visit those places. I get more blessed than us being of help to them. Especially the Home for Handicapped, which was founded by an uncle of mine because he himself had polio. And then God used him in establishing that home. And when you go to their worship service, I mean, you feel exactly as though you are in heaven. Because all these disabled children crawling on the ground, coming for the service, and they beautifully sing and have a worship time with them. Every time we go there, we try to do that. Also, we are involved in supporting a leprosy hospital. About 30, 40 miles from the town I used to live in.
Dr. Rasalam gives all the glory to God.
One thing I believe in my life, and of course in my practice with patients, is the healing coming from God. And my goal is ultimately to be able to reach those patients to the faith in Jesus Christ. And my goal is to plant seeds. Somebody else may water, and God can let God give the growth. So that's our plan, to plant seeds in the lives of people. Plant the best thing that they can ever have for eternity. So I try not to have them dependent on me. I want them to be depending on Jesus and the Word of God. I always tell patients, I know I cannot heal you, but I know a person that has never sent away without healing, and that's Jesus. And
thanks so much to Dr. Rasalam and the Pathway Wellness Center.